You will notice we sing. pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. I'd love for you to concentrate.
And they are delivered in this time of trial. They are delivered a very special, a special message that's been delivered to us as a Christian and should be delivered to everyone else also. That most important message ever given, that message that I believe law is going to continue and continue and continue. The Bible says the word, let the whole world know about the message of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
I believe with all my heart, and would like to propose to you today, that the greatest season of joy that's ever been brought to this world was the season and the first Christmas when Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem. Amen?
Amen?
And I think that every Christmas, we get to taste a little bit of what that first Christmas was like.
Amen.
Now, I didn't get to be there, and I didn't get to see Jesus being born, and I didn't get to be a part of that, and that would have been great. But I'll tell you what, I feel a little bit, in a small way, how they felt so many, many years ago, and getting to experience this Christmas today. I think about all the family that we get to be with, and all the loved ones that we get to share with, and we get to give something. Many times in our family, we get to give a token of a gift to somebody just to let them know that we do care for them and we do love them.
Yeah.
I want to just dissect a couple of verses with you, and then we're going to let you go home today. And I would like for you to look with me in your Bible, of course, and Luke chapter 2 and verse 11, if you have it. And let's get it open. We're going to go back to verse 10. It says in verse 10, And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. I want you to notice those first two words, fear not. Anybody see those words with me?
Yeah.
Fear not. Now, back in, I don't know, was it the late 90s or 2000s? You know, they had these no fear shirts. Anybody remember the no fear shirts? How many of you had a no fear, make your fearless, right? Just keep that shirt on. You can do anything, you know? I'm eating a chocolate candy bar. I don't care if I got diabetes. Anyway, right? No fear. I'm going for it, right? But, yeah, this is right. But, you know, you remember the no fear. And I don't know if most of them knew that was straight out of the Bible, you know? A bunch of rebels. Fear not. But that company that made those, I don't know, some kind of merchandising campaign or whatever it was. But the general purpose was to sell clothes by encouraging people to try things that they normally wouldn't do. Maybe to go bungee jumping or snowboarding or, I don't know, something extreme. I don't know, just to try something that you wouldn't normally do. But I'll tell you this, it came straight out of the Bible. And these people, these shepherds, were definitely, Pastor Rick mentioned last night in our new Christmas Eve service. We did have church band last night and this morning.
Amen.
He said, what did he say last night? I mean, basically, he quoted some of my sermon here. I think he caught it from me. But no, it says, fear not. And what they're saying, hey, if you saw an angel and you're in the middle of the night on your watch, it says, you Anybody ever worked midnights before?
Yeah.
Sometimes you're not, okay, you're there, but you're kind of, you're not there. Anybody ever worked and you're there? I mean, you're working, but it's, you know how it is, right? It's midnights. And I've been through that. Then can you imagine an angel appearing before you and a bright light shining right on you? You would be afraid. I promise you, I would be afraid. And so, of course, the first message there was, fear not. Don't fear the angels. Don't fear. Everything's going to be okay. And the second thing they say is, here we are in verse 8. It says, fear not, for behold, I bring you what you say. Good and high. Can you say it? I just want to clarify, it's for everybody. Amen?
Amen.
We're going to have people that walk into this church that don't, may not look like you. Maybe they're not dressed like you. Maybe they're, we've had homeless people walk into the church. We treat homeless, we bring them in. If they're genuine, they want to hear, they want to grow, they want to know about Jesus, they're welcome to come.
Right.
We don't care what your status is, we don't care where you're from. If you're genuine and you want to hear about Jesus, hey, we're ready to teach and tell you about Jesus. All of you, we're in the city of David, Bethlehem, of course, a Savior. And he defines it wasn't just a Savior, like someone who's going to deliver us our nation, or someone who's going to, help us win a victory over another country or win a battle. No, he says the Savior defined, which is Christ, the Lord. He is the Messiah. This Savior can't be mixed up with anybody else. He's not just a good leader or a good person or a good prophet. He isn't just a nice man. He isn't just a strong leader or a warrior. No. Christ, the Lord, the Christos, the Anointed, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, the Lord. So you say, Pastor Beard, what are you saying? I'm saying that we have a season of joy because we have Jesus Christ. The gospel is given to us by these angels, to the shepherds, and today we have that same message. Jesus Christ came to us, born in Bethlehem, and he came to save us from our sins. He is truly the Savior of this world. There's a song that I like. It's called Ring the Bells. Anybody ever heard that before? I love that song. Ring the Bells. I'd sing it. I'm sick. I can try it, though. It goes something like this. Ring the bells, ring the bells. Let the whole world know Christ was born in Bethlehem many years ago. Born to die that man might live, came to earth new life to give. Born of Mary, born so low many years ago. God the Father gave His Son, gave His own beloved to this wicked, sinful earth, to bring mankind His love new birth. Ring the bells, ring the bells. Let the whole world know Christ the Savior, He lives today. Sundays, why are these crazy people doing it? on a Christmas day and you stopped in, if you're here today and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, man, it would, you don't understand how excited in our church we would all be that if you would receive Jesus Christ and call upon the name of the Lord. The Bible says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. And if you would call upon Jesus today, ask him to be your Savior. We'd love to be a help.